Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a long division problem with polynomials. So we've been given this fraction, 3x cubed minus 2x squared plus 4x minus 3, divided by another polynomial, x squared plus 3x plus 3, and we need to perform long division with these polynomials in order to simplify the fraction. So this is no different than long division that you would have learned in elementary school, except that this time we're going to be dividing polynomials. So the first thing to know is that you always remember long division. We've got our format like this. We're going to put the numerator inside. So we've got 3x cubed minus 2x squared plus 4x minus 3. And then we're going to put the denominator on the outside. So x squared plus 3x plus 3. Right? And just like we've learned with long division before, you start this problem by figuring out what to multiply by x squared in order to get 3x cubed. So we would have to multiply x squared by 3x to get 3x cubed, right? And the reason we do that is because now that we figured out that it's 3x, we're going to take 3x and multiply it through this part here. So we'll do 3x times each of these terms. So 3x times x squared gives us 3x cubed. Then we'll do 3x times 3x, which gives us a positive 9x squared. And then 3x times 3 gives us a positive 9x. So once we've multiplied through, we're going to subtract this polynomial from the one above it. So when we do that, you notice that we get 3x cubed minus 3x cubed, so we get a 0 out in front. And that was the whole point of making sure that this 3x here was something that we could multiply by x squared to match 3x cubed here, because we wanted these to cancel. So we'll get 0, we'll get negative 2x squared. This will be a minus 9x squared because of the negative sign out in front here. So negative 2x squared minus 9x squared is a negative 11x squared. And then this will be a minus 9x because we've got 4x minus out in front here, minus 9x. So that'll give us a negative 5x. And then once we've performed that subtraction, we always want to bring down the next term in our original numerator. So this 3, negative 3, comes down, and we end up with negative 3, like that. And now we perform the same concept again. So what would we have to multiply by x squared to get 11x squared? Of course, that would be negative 11. So once we've identified that, we go ahead and multiply negative 11 through each term of x squared plus 3x plus 3. So we get negative 11x squared minus 33x. And then minus 33. And once we've done that, we can go ahead and put this in parentheses, and we're going to be subtracting, always. You always subtract. So obviously we'll get negative 11x squared, because we have the double negative here, negative and negative, we'll get negative 11x squared plus 11x squared, which will be 0. So notice we have the canceling again. Then we'll get negative 5x instead of a minus 33x. It'll be a double negative again. So we'll get negative 5x plus 33x. And that'll give us a positive 28x. Then negative 3 minus a negative 33 would be negative 3 plus 33, which would give us a positive 30. So now, at this point, notice we don't have any more terms out here to bring down, right? So we're done with that part. We could figure out what to multiply by x squared to get 28x, but if we did that, we would realize that we had to multiply by 28 divided by x. 28 divided by x is what you would have to multiply by x squared to get 28x. And whenever we run into that, whenever we realize that we'd need to multiply by a fraction, we know that we've gotten to the end where we're going to call the rest of what's left here the remainder. Because this part, multiplying by a fraction like that, starts getting too complicated. So what we do is we stop there and we say that the simplified polynomial is now first this part, whatever we got up here, everything up here. So that's 3x minus 11. So we'd say that it's 3x minus 11 plus the remainder, which is what's left down here. So 28x plus 30, the remainder, divided by everything here that was outside our division bracket. So we get x squared plus 3x plus 3, right? Our original denominator. So this is the part from the top here. And then this whole thing right here, the second part, is the remainder. So we can call that our final answer. That's as far as we can get in terms of the long division. I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!